Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and Bannock, and welcome to episode 4 of the Spike Nation Weekly Podcast. I'm your host, Jordan Campos, aka fortylicks, and in today's episode, we get deep down and dirty with my male partner, Nick, and his Xbox One. Also, an episode of Embarrassing Story of the Week. Remember, you can find it all here at the Spike Nation Weekly Podcast. So for this week's embarrassing story, I'm going to tell you about the time I was in middle school, 8th grade, and a young Hayden Panettiere was in 6th grade. Now, this girl was probably 10, 11 years old, and she had just did Remember the Titans. And I remember it being a pretty big deal in my school. So one day, I'm wandering the halls, and I'm trying to impress this girl next to me. And I don't know why I thought impressing her meant torturing a 11-year-old Hayden Panettiere, who has more talent in her middle finger than I do will ever have in my life. So we're walking in the hall, and she's walking by us, and she couldn't be more innocent girl in school. I mean, backpack, books held up to her chest, just mind her own business walking down the hall, and my dipshit self had to go, "Hey Blake, you know what movie really sucked? Remember the Titans." Now, it wouldn't be a big deal if I did that once. I mean, my frontal lobe is not developed, so you really can't blame me for this. Well, you can, and you should. But I was an idiot. And the reason it gets worse is because I think I did it maybe 3 times that day to her. And I felt really, really high. I don't know why I felt high off of torturing a young girl. But later on that day, my badass 13-year-old pothead self had to stay after school for science, because God knows what my grades were at this point. And guess who shows up? But a pissed off Hayden Panettiere mom. And she fucking blew off on me right outside that class. Like, screaming and yelling. And I thought I was so cool. I just put my headphones on and tried to walk away. But no, this woman grabbed my headphones off and gave me an earful. And at the time, I thought she was a bitch. And that it was totally wrong for her to yell at me. But, I realized that I should have gotten a fucking beating. She should have ran into the classroom and grabbed a ruler and just let me have it, because I was a dick. And to this day, I have friends that like hang out with her in California, good friends. And I remember when I was working at the movie theater, she came up with her boyfriend, who I knew, and I liked her boyfriend. He was like a really cool guy. And I remember they showed up and he said hi to me. And you know what? This gives her really credit of like, how big she was. She had no clue who I was. She didn't remember that instance for a second. She just fucking, that was the worst part of it. Like, she just saw right through me, like, "All right, give me some fucking popcorn, large drink, large soda. Let's do it." And, you know what? She deserved it. Cause I was a dick. And, that's 40 Licks embarrassing story of the week in one take. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and trust me, believe it or not, there's plenty more in the vault. Hey guys, I just wanted to thank you all for making my video the most commented video of Spike Nation history. And if you got a couple extra bucks today, just donate. That's all. Enjoy the rest of the show.
Hey guys, and welcome to a very special edition of 40 Licks Gaming Corner.
I'm here with my very special friend, Nick. Nick, how are you doing today?
Doing all right.
All right.
I am very special.
So, Nick, I have to say what's very special about you is that you've been my friend for a very long time, and you also have an Xbox One.
I do.
So that's what brings you over my house today. And, Nick, just pretend for the audience that you have never opened your Xbox One before, that the two, maybe 1 month ago that you bought it, you just looked at it, and you did not touch it, and this is the first time that me and you are seeing, because it's my first time. And, you know, since we share so many first times, Nick, I want this to be another very special first time.
All right.
So let's go up. Is there other things in here, or is this, like, just when you found it, when you never opened it before? Okay, you know what? I hope there's something that's not supposed to be shipped in here. Like, oh, Nick, this empty condom wrapper. Microsoft's so kind for giving you this empty condom wrapper. All right, but yeah, that's such a joke, because Nick would never use condoms.
I wouldn't.
All right, so let's open up this. I love the way Microsoft packages this console.
Very neat. Everything's separated, very organized.
This is exactly how I would pack it up. So this is my first time holding the controller, and it's fucking sexy. But it's kind of small. These joysticks are kind of small for my big thumbs.
Big bear hands.
They are dwarfing these joysticks. But they stick nice. What do you think about the controller, Nick? Have you ever seen this prior to this Xbox opening?
Only in stores.
Oh my god.
No, I like this controller better than the Xbox 360.
All right. Have you ever... apparently, there's these rumble sensors in the joysticks. Now, I see you have Call of Duty Ghosts. I know you've never played Call of Duty Ghosts, but does it utilize the joysticks? I don't think it does, actually. I don't think it utilizes the rumble feedback triggers that are on there. I think the only game that might activate these triggers is Forza, so that might be a first for you.
It will.
So let's buy Forza and let's check that out. All right, so we have the power brick, which honestly is the same exact thing from the other one. It's just a giant big hunk of plastic.
Yep.
And it looks nicer, and it definitely has sharper edges. You could definitely use this as a weapon.
You can peel that.
The other one has rounded edges.
Peel
I don't
that
understand.
Plastic off, and they'll actually do something for the first time.
Yeah, I mean, no, you keep the plastic on, and then when you murder somebody and get blood on it, then you take the plastic off. That's come on, Nick. That's why Microsoft has it there. All right, we have the Kinect, and I actually have. We could take out my Kinect and compare, but let's not do that because that would be a quality podcast, and we don't do that here.
No.
So it's nice.
Yeah.
It's
it recognizes
smaller.
You.
And it looks nice. It has that high gloss though, so you can, as soon as you touch it, it just gets a fingerprint. But it's nice. It has its own vent, and I like that new Xbox logo. All right, let's take that out. This is what everybody didn't want the console to have. All right, so here comes the Kinect. They're going to get rid of it, I'm telling you. In less than 3 years, you're going to have a console without the Kinect.
I don't use it for anything except that it recognizes me to sign on when I do set that up, because I've never opened this before.
So, Nick, speaking of never opening this, this is the Xbox One!
It is.
Oh, my God, it's big.
It's heavy.
Big, fat, and American. It's just like me.
It is.
Oh, man.
It's a little blacker than you.
It's a little blacker than me, but you'd never see me after a long vacation, Nick.
Oh.
So it has... like a USB thing on the side.
Yeah,
it looks nice. Vents everywhere. It's completely vent.
No more red rings.
No more red rings. I'm sure there's something else they're gonna call it.
Oh yeah, something will happen.
Yes. All right. So I guess what we'll do is we'll pause it right here and we'll take a little break and we'll hook this thing up and we'll start a game up and we'll take it from there. So we'll be right back, guys. And Nick, remember, this is the
first time I played it.
All right, well, we're back. And we played some FIFA, and we played some Killer Instinct. And Killer Instinct,
you're pretty bad at.
I was pretty horrible at. And it looked okay. But yeah, I didn't get it. And I thought I was going to like it better, but yeah, not my thing. But it looked pretty. So that's all that matters. And FIFA looked really nice. I didn't play. But Nick won. That was a good job, Nick. And right now we're going to play some Call of Duty Ghosts. Something I might be a little better at.
Probably.
So you made it to level 55, so you've been playing a lot, huh?
I've been going at it.
Are you going to prestige?
Yeah, probably. See, look at all the things I can't get to because you're not on yet.
Clan. I don't even know if they added to clans. I wouldn't feel too... That might be one of those launch things.
These are my soldiers. You get different guys. You have to unlock.
Is it like different perks per one or no?
Not really.
Just...
This is the guy I mainly use.
Mahal?
I guess.
Mulholland Drive?
Yeah.
Alright, so let's kill some people.
It's all about domination and it's going to come out a lot of points. But we'll just go to Team Deathmatch first.
Yeah, I always like the domination ones too.
We got some double XP. Perks work well. You don't really need a second gun, because then you get another perk that you can use.
I never picked the ones with second guns. I'd always pick the
one. No, like, you don't even need your pistol. Get rid of your pistol and you get another perk.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah, no, I like that. That was from either Black Ops 2 or Black Ops the Division. No, not the Division. Black Ops
2. One.
Black Ops 2, you got to switch out your stuff. And you can trade in your second gun for, like, a... I think it's a 10 loadout. You can pick, like, any 10 out of 10 perks and stuff. And you can sacrifice your gun and stuff. So we'll switch off every death. So, I'll just go with your gun choices. So let's see. So it looks nice. I mean, it's Call of Duty. And I know that it, as much as they like to boast, I know that they didn't spend too much time on this game.
No. There's a few things that you could, like, that change during the game. Like, this map you can blow up.
Yeah, like the Levolution, like Battlefield. Well, it looks nice. Yeah, so, I noticed there's a little more particles running around, and the grass is blurred. Normally, with Call of Duty, the glass is, like, flat. So you just got wrecked by somebody. They knifed you. I didn't even see that guy either. So that's Call of Duty. You get knifed.
Yeah, it happens.
So you can
lean around corners now.
Alright, so you just womp these two guys.
Yeah. Look at that, you can lean around.
Oh, you can lean. I know that's like not even something you should be like boasting about, but that's new to Call of Duty. I don't think it's ever had that.
I got blown up by an IED.
So let me switch out how to play it. So let's see. I have
C4 instead of grenades.
Okay.
Just
how do you lean?
When you go up to a corner, you see that there'll be a little arrow.
Yeah.
No, like you lean.
Oh, you have to be up to a corner.
Yeah.
See, I just died. Well, let me get another one. Like, that was just my test out of death. My inner 5-year-old's like, no, that one didn't count. That one. I get another one. See, I play Call of Duty on a computer monitor. I find it a little easier. I don't know. I get a little disoriented playing on a big TV. Even though people are like, oh, you know, the bigger the better. See?
There's floating briefcases that you get for challenges, and that's how you get care packages in this one.
What are you throwing? Oh, yeah, I heard that. Like, and people can steal it like the regular care packages, right?
Yeah. Slide.
That's pretty sweet.
I like the slide.
That's worth it right there. You like when Marty McFly does like his guitar solo and then at the end. Or like the guy from The Who just does the power slide at the end. Now, Call of Duty gets like a bad reputation, but I think it's a good game. And I think just because jocks play it, people started hating on it, but it wasn't like a true game. But man, we had some good memories of Call of Duty. We were playing the original Modern Warfare. We were jamming on that thing. Team Tactical.
We played the shit out of that game.
And I remember that was like a niche, like not even a lot of people played that one. When people were still playing Gears of War, there's like a guy just AFK right there on the left. Go back. Yeah, right there. You still didn't even get the kill! I told you about it, you like ran up, you ran up. Your bullets did like a silhouette around. Now that guy was invisible. Wait, is there like something on this guy?
No, there's a guy over here.
You know what game was good that they didn't do any updates for and they didn't release any maps was the Battlefield 1943.
That was the best $15 I've ever.
I don't know, they released that like island map where you can just fly around the Wake Island.
Yeah.
And then that was it. That was like after the first month it came out. That was when we met Major Nelson.
Yeah, it was.
And I stole his plane. We were such douchebags.
Flew around behind him shooting him.
Now, is there a nuke in this or something? I mean, I doubt you've gotten it yet since you only had it for that month. But is there, you is get, there some sort of...
You get, when you set up your things, like...
They have dogs.
The dogs aren't so bad, because only one.
I heard they've released dog skins.
Yeah. Yeah, you can get a wolf instead of...
Are you playing this with anybody, like any buddies, or you're the only one that has it?
I have no friends on Xbox One.
No one has it, honestly. I don't know many people that even have the PS4. I know, like, one or two.
Still want the PS4.
We're going to get Titanfall. That's where the jam's going to be.
Yeah, they definitely need to release games.
Oh, that's a dog. I need to paint your face. Did you see that, like, third-person mode they had in the dog? So is that your care package thing?
That is my... No, that's my,
Like an ammo or something?
Yeah.
You got a gun out of it.
It's a weapon crate.
And you said, little jam on this. Alright, so...
This one we definitely have to set up, like, TV. It looks much better. Easier to see people and stuff.
Now, is this a random weapon that pops out of there?
Yeah.
But it could be... It's like in Zombies, when you get that crate.
Yeah.
There.
Yeah.
That's pretty sweet. And is that like a care package or a perk someone can throw up?
Forgetting
like a... Okay, so you got a couple kills. Oh, that was a shotgun.
No, that was a rifle. You shot him in the face, though.
That's what I do.
You got one, buddy.
I got one before, too. Just one. See, I always play with the SMGs. Like, I'm always an SMG guy. See, I was the last kill.
Yeah, you were.
I got the best kill and then we lost. Yeah, let me see that. Because I am kind of dangerous. Oh, wait, we get to watch me on the kill cam. Look at me, running around like... Oh, no, it was not the last kill.
Wait. Oh, yeah, you got killed right before that guy.
So I'm not an asshole.
So you can get that thing. That just happened in the background. Yeah, and then the mat and it's like changes completely.
It's like Rosie O'Donnell just cleaves everywhere.
Yeah. But you have to, I think you have to get 25 kills without dying, or a care package.
Oh, so they have it in the care package. That was always like an urban legend in like, I forgot what Modern Warfare, they were like,
the nuke?
Yeah, if you get the nuke and the care package and you hacked, if you had like a, what were those modded Xbox called? I don't know, something. They would mod it, and they had like a new name for it, and everyone's like, oh man, I got this Xbox mod. And we got the new care packages. So these guns look pretty nice. I always like the Vector. Vector
looks really cool. I don't think I have enough points to help.
Oh, so you didn't unlock it.
Yeah.
Alright. So, I guess we'll cut it off for the Call of Duty. And then we'll do like a wrap up. We'll play a little bit longer. Maybe we'll freshen up. And we'll come back with some more impressions. So, you're still listening, which...
Probably aren't.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be listening.
Honestly, I don't blame you. I'm going to be going back and editing this and being just like...
Oh, I hate it.
Why did I ever start the Spike Nation Weekly Podcast?
Why did I invite Nick over?
Well, you're getting paid, so...
Oh.
Well, sexual favors.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't have much of a loan.
That's not like getting paid.
I have some Bitcoin. You know, pay some hypothetical Bitcoins.
I'll take the Bitcoins.
Yeah, sure. Alright, so we'll be back. Spike Nation.
Hey guys, thanks for bearing through the audio quality on that one. Just wanted to give a big thanks from my buddy Nick for bringing over his Xbox One. And this week's music submission comes from my friend Mike. You can find him under the name Naughty Bits. This track is called La Musica. Thanks for listening. And remember, if it's not spiked, don't drink it. Speed up.
Peter.